So after you're done setting up your audio interface, we've got it plugged in, we've got the inputs and the outputs configured. One thing you're gonna wanna take a look at, again, we're going back to the preferences in Ableton Live, and we're going to the audio tab. One thing you're gonna wanna take a look at is your latency. Now, what does that mean? That is the amount of time from when a signal originally goes into the audio input to the time that it actually comes back out of the speakers. In the digital audio world, we're always fighting latency, we're always trying to reduce it, and Ableton has some cool features built in to really optimize that. So first and foremost, we're gonna look at our buffer size, a little segment of audio that Ableton Live is always kind of hanging onto in case there's any dropouts. You can always kind of reach back into the well and grab it. It's measured in terms of samples. Generally speaking, you want the buffer as small as possible. The trade-off there is the hit on your CPU. Most modern laptops, say the past couple years, can run pretty comfortably in the 128 to 256 sample range. Ableton Live by default will be at 512. I generally like to kick it down to 128. So we're gonna knock it down to 128, and then Ableton Live nicely will calculate what the input and output latency is. Here, the overall latency is gonna end up being 10 milliseconds. That's pretty small if you really think about it. So lowest buffer size possible, try to get under 10 milliseconds if you can. Watch for your CPU. If you start hearing crickling, crackling in your audio, and you're hearing audio dropouts, take the buffer back up. But what happens after you've got multiple tracks, you're running multiple effects, and the CPU is really working hard at the mix stage? Low latency when tracking, and feel free to take the buffer size and the resulting latency back up when you're in the mix stage. So we have connected our audio interface. We've gotten it set up in Ableton Live. We've optimized our latency settings, and now we're ready to record. So my good friend Tibor here has come to play the guitar a bit for us, and we're gonna take a quick look at how to actually record some audio, in this case, a guitar amp that is mic'd up running into the audio interface. So if you would, sir, maybe give you a little jam here. What I'm gonna be watching for is I'm gonna be increasing the gain on channel one of my audio interface, and I'm gonna be watching the level here in Ableton Live to try to get it into a nice range. Doesn't have to be all the way to the top of the level meter. Maybe usually keep it about 6 dB off from the top, but as Tibor is playing, I'm just gonna turn up the gain. I'm gonna be watching the meter here, and as it increases, you can see the green bar going up. And that's a nice, healthy recording volume. Now, some audio interfaces are different. This is more of a mixer, so you've got some extra EQ and stuff, but generally speaking, you're gonna take a mic, you're gonna plug it into one of the inputs, you're gonna turn up the gain until you get to the right level in your DAW, and then you're gonna hit record and you're gonna play some funky music. That concludes our introductory tutorial, setting up an audio interface, configuring Ableton Live, recording some guitar. From here, really, the sky's the limit. We're gonna be spending a lot more time talking about Ableton, talking about music production on a computer, generally speaking, talking more about plugins, talking about all the cool stuff that you can do when you bring a computer and bring software into your gear collection, into the bedroom studio, into the rehearsal space, and we're gonna see where it takes us. Thanks.